There are many advantages to connecting a MacBook to an HDTV. You can use it as a huge second computer monitor or watch your favorite shows and YouTube videos on it. But without an HDMI port on the MacBook, the way to connect the two together might not be immediately apparent. But keep watching and I'll show you how to do it. It seems like there's an adapter for everything, and that's the case here. We'll need a Thunderbolt to HDMI adapter. This is actually a 3-in-1 adapter because I wanted to be flexible and be able to connect my MacBook to a variety of monitors. The 3-in-1 means I can connect to DVI, HDMI, and Display Port monitors. Connections are really simple. Just plug the Thunderbolt plug into the MacBook, then plug your HDMI cable into the adapter. Now insert the other end of the HDMI cable to one of your TV inputs. Make sure to select the correct input on your TV. Immediately, you can see that I've got my MacBook's desktop on my TV. Taking a closer look, I hope you can see that the desktop is not filling the entire screen. That's because it's using the resolution of my MacBook screen. But the nice thing is that we can really take advantage of my TV's full resolution by changing a simple setting. So if you go to Settings and then click on Displays, there's a drop-down menu that will allow the MacBook to scale to the TV's native resolution. I'll select the name of my TV and the resolution jumps to 1920 by 1080, and now the desktop fills the entire screen. And depending on your monitor, you'll have different resolutions available. So now I can use my HDTV as a big computer monitor, or I can enjoy watching videos from YouTube and other websites on my TV. It's really simple with this adapter, and I like that it has other inputs so I can use it on other monitors and projectors. I picked up this adapter for about $12 on Amazon, so it's a really inexpensive solution. I'll leave a link to the actual adapter I'm using down in the description. It's been really nice to have this adapter in my computer bag. Oh, and one last thing, I just want to let you know that audio does come through this cable, so we've got video and audio coming through this single connection. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more how-to videos and product reviews. Want to see other videos I produce? Just click on the thumbnails to watch.